Sometimes Mother Nature needs a little help. That's why I'm here today.
Believe it or not, I am only 10 minutes outside of Reno at the Galena Creek Visitor Center. And the reason I'm here is because I'm talking to its director, Gwen Bourne. They have some amazing programs that are going on that directly affect you and me.
The Galena Creek Visitor Center offers a doorway to nature and strives to connect people with the outdoors.
Gwen? Hey, it's John. How are you?
Nice to meet you.
You have a beautiful center here. I got to say, the setting is great. It's a really great place to come visit.
Thank you. We're very fortunate. This is Washoe County and U.S. Forest Service and the Great Basin Institute collaboration. We have about 200-300 research scientists at any given time who work mainly with federal partners on projects such as desert tortoise, such as quagga mussel, sensitive species habitat.
How did you get into this? How did this become your passion?
Well, that's a good question. My background's education and administration, and my love is always the outdoors. And so to be able to combine the three is an amazing treat for me, and to be able to work with people who are also passionate about the environment and about getting kids and community connected to nature, it's a no-brainer.
Were you outside a lot as a kid?
I was. I actually went to a summer camp where I was able to walk barefoot on the trails, up mountains, walk through creeks and streams, and never looked back.
Working with children, getting them outside and into nature, is another of the center's important missions.
So we focus mainly on our local population, Washoe County kids, because our educators tell us that 70% of our local kids have never even been in a forest. So what does that mean for the future of forest conservation and protection? And what does it mean for those individual kids? Their mental health, their physical health.
I saw that you have something outside.
We do. We have the largest insect hotel in Nevada. And Sandy Rowley's out there. She's one of our partners with the bee habitat. And she can show it to you.
Oh, I got to go see this. Gwen, thanks for taking the time.
Great meeting you, John.
A dedicated advocate for bees, Sandy Rowley works as a coordinator for Beyond Pesticides. She's been the driving force behind the creation of this insect hotel.
Sandy, hey, it's John.
Hi, nice to see you.
I understand you're the bee team.
Yes. Queen bee.
Queen bee. I know you know a lot about them, and I'm dying to hear about this because they're in the news now all the time, but the first thing I want to do is I want to ask you about this display over here. Can we go take a look?
Yes, I'd love to show you around.
Let's go. All right, this is crazy looking. What's going on here? What am I looking at?
This is an insect hotel. They're very popular in Europe. We took that idea that they use in Germany to help protect their pollinators, and we built our own American version of an insect hotel.
What purpose does it serve?
This is a habitat, a safe haven for pollinators. Not just native bees or bumblebees, but ladybugs, dragonflies, flies, even wasps. Potter wasps are good beneficial bugs for your garden, and they're welcome here as well.
It's big, but this is something that people can do at home, right?
Oh, most definitely. You can get a small birdhouse and take the front off of it and then stuff it with straw, with twigs, pine cones, anything that you find out in nature.
Something not treated with pesticides?
Oh, most important. It's not a good idea to build a bee hotel out of wood that has insecticides in it and then invite nature to it.
Right. So, well, this is interesting because right now I'm reading in the news, I think a lot of people are, about the population of bees is being decimated. Is that true? How bad is it? And why is this happening?
It's terrifying, actually, if you look at the numbers. Last year in the States alone, 40 to 60% of beekeepers lost their hives.
The overuse of pesticides and habitat destruction are contributing to something called colony collapse disorder. It occurs when the worker bees disappear, leaving the queen to fend for herself.
Why do we care?
Oh gosh, 90% of all of the plants on Earth are pollinated by bees and other pollinators. 75% of all the food that we survive off of is pollinated by bees and other pollinators.
So if I make a linear connection to what you're saying, if we lose the bees, we lose our food. Suddenly, this isn't just decoration, what we're talking about here. This is vital.
This is important. So this bee hotel, it's a statement piece, but it's also providing a safe haven for pollinators, not just bees. It's for stingless bees as well, non-aggressive bees, but it's also for ladybugs and other beetles and insects that pollinate our foods for free.
So what if somebody sees this and they said, I don't want bees in my backyard, they're gonna sting me. Does that happen?
No. Okay, so this is not for honeybees. Honeybees aren't native to North America. Honeybees are aggressive when they're protecting their hive. They need a hive. These bees are mason bees or leaf cutter bees. There's some of them, they don't even have stingers. Mm. And they're not aggressive because they don't have a hive. They're solitary bees. And they do a better job at pollinating crops than honeybees do.
How did you get so passionate about this?
I've always been passionate about bees. It's a long story. When I was born, I was premature. I weighed about 4 pounds, 2 ounces. Doctor sent me home to die. My grandfather said, nope, I'm gonna fix this. He started feeding me raw honey, egg, and milk, and then voila, I'm still here today. So I've always had a love for them and a respect for them.
I have a lot of respect for you. I learned
you.
A lot today. I see the value of this, and with the numbers that you gave me, it's so alarming. I think everybody should do what they can to see if we can get this thing going in the other direction.
Yeah, everyone can do something. Plant organic plants in your yard. Make sure they're certified organic. It's extremely important. Build a little bee hotel. You can even get a piece of wood like this, a log, drill some holes in it, different various sizes, and set it in your garden. And it's a great way to help the pollinators out. You've got to get up and you got to start doing something now.
Now. Sandy, thank you so much. It really was great talking to you today.
Thank you.
We've all heard about the circle of life, and today we saw it firsthand. We met Gwen, who had such a profound experience being outdoors when she was a child, now fights to make sure that other children have that same experience. And Sandy, who had her life changed by bees, is now fighting to save their lives. It's a circle of life that we all need to get involved in before it's too late.
You can help the bee population, the environment, and human beings too, by building a habitat in your backyard. Check out the website on the screen for more information.